Hi guys, I'm Sjoe Elfink and this is my self-made fully autonomous vehicle capable of driving all by itself over real public roads using the most modern artificial intelligence and computer vision techniques. It is based on an electric ATV and it is programmed using Python. And the best thing is that it is completely open source and that you can build it yourself for free. So, let's get started. I will first start with showing some of the advanced decision-making capabilities that the ATV has. First of all, the ATV is capable of driving fully autonomously on a straight road. Even if the road does not have any clear road markings, the ATV can decide what throttle response and steering response is needed for any specific case. Here you can for example see that it can correct itself when it goes off the center of the road. Secondly, the autonomous ATV can perform left and right turns. It does not matter which angle the turn is, it can autonomously adjust its steering response to the curvature of the road. I can even sit on the ATV while it's driving autonomously, which is an amazing feeling. So, how can the ATV know what to do? The first step that the ATV takes is to segment the incoming image. This gives the computer a better understanding of the situation. After that, the segmented image is sent to the driving network. This driving network is an end-to-end artificial intelligence network trained on my driving behavior. I have learned the computer how to drive by first showing how I drive. After training the computer on my driving data, it shows the exact same driving behavior as me and thus knows the right steering and throttle values for any situation. After the driving network has predicted the right steering and throttle response, these values are sent to the control module. This module runs a closed loop feedback controller which will perform the steering and throttle action. These actions are then sent over a USB cable to the embedded computer on the ATV, which sends the correct electric signals to the drivetrain and steering actuator. The embedded computer also returns the current status of the ATV so that the control module can act on the current state of the vehicle. If you are even more interested in the inner workings of these systems and how I created them, then watch my two-part video series on YouTube. In the first part I show how I created the electronical systems, and in the second part I'm going to show you how I created the software. While the results are already very impressive, I'm not satisfied yet. I want the ATV to drive faster and more reliable. Therefore, I'm going to build a version 2.0. This will have a completely improved chassis since the current chassis has a lot of play in the steering system and a big stroke in its wheels. This makes the camera wobble and greatly reduces the accuracy of the steering system and its feedback controller. Secondly, I'm going to give the ATV a much better camera. It is already capable of driving like this using only a 640x420 resolution camera. Can you imagine what it can do with a full HD camera? This gives it much more data to work with. I'm also going to implement a new segmentation model which will run much faster. The current driving model runs at 15 fps and the segmentation model only at 3 fps. By improving the segmentation model, I will get over 50 fps. This will make the ATV much more responsive. Also, the computer has shown some amazing capability of learning by itself what pedestrians are and adjusting its speed accordingly. Here you can see it stopping for me. I am planning to continue with this to learn the computer to dynamically adjust its throttle for any road obstacles like pedestrians, cars, or any other road blockings. And as last, I will train the driving model on much more driving data. The current system is only trained on 4 hours of driving. In version 2.0, I will be driving much more, making the computer much better at driving. We as humans, for example, can't drive a car flawlessly with only 4 hours of experience. This is exactly the same for a computer. If you want to see this faster and more precise version 2.0, then subscribe to my channel. I am also working on another project where I am making a drone which can shoot a series of obstacles fully autonomously. This works by using a Jetson Nano and Facebook's new Detectron framework. If you want to see how I made it and how it works, then also subscribe to my channel. And as always, everything will be open source and free for everyone to use and experiment. So, I will see you in the next video.